extend my gratitude to the Vice Chancellor of Tamil Nadu Teachers Education, Dr. Balakrishnan sir, and the organizing secretary, Dr. Nagasubramaniam sir, for giving me this opportunity to be a part of this workshop. And I'm also glad to meet you all in this online forum. And I think this must be one of the most awaited sessions in the workshop. And I also hope that I can give you some good source of information for you all to create some good video, educational video. And yesterday, Dr. Suresh Kumar sir said about the basics of educational video content creation. And he said about some steps involved, and he quoted a lot of studies. So that shows how much impact that educational videos are having among this today's generation. And Mr. Gideon, he also spoke about some technical terms, and he also listed out the steps involved in creating video content. He also gave some good tips. It was amazing. And he said about panning, zooming, positioning, composing, all that. I think you all must be very clear about those things. And now, to my point, from my experience, I would like to tell you that there are two things very, very important. One is content knowledge. You should have a good content knowledge before creating an educational video. The vast content knowledge is very, very important. The second is creative ideas, where you will decide what to do, where you want to include the video clip, where you want to put the images, what kind of animations you have to do, all that you have to get from your idea. Then the rest of things is with your fingertips. You can make the video, okay? Then now we have to understand the attention span of today's generation. Earlier days, we used to watch dramas. People used to watch dramas for 5 to 4 hours. Now we have made movies that we are watching for 2.5 to 3 hours. And especially in my home, we only watch English movies. The only reason is that will over in 1 to 1.5 hours. If you watch other language movies, it goes from 2.5 hours to 3 hours. And nowadays, people stopped watching movies from TVs after this Netflix and Hotstar, Sun Direct have come. So they are watching the movies in the application itself because they don't want this advertisement headache. And when compared to attention span, the social media made this attention span to 4 minutes. So we are sharing some videos that is for 4 minutes or 2-5 minutes. And TikTok, it has made it to be less than 1 minute. So nowadays, today's generation's attention span is very, very less. So it is very, very important when you are creating educational video to introduce the element of interest in each and every frame. You have to introduce the element of interest so that the learners will sustain to learn or watch the video from the beginning to the end. So for that, we need some animated content, animated videos, little video clips, real-time videos, some attractive images. So you should know to select all the sources from the available, like we can directly take it from internet. We don't need to go anywhere. So now today in this session, I'm going to demonstrate some 5 applications that will be very useful for you to create the entire video content with good quality. That is more important. You can create it with good quality. So let me start with the first application. Sir, I'm going to share my screen, sir.
Yes, ma'am. You can start.
Okay, sir.
So you have all the...
Hope you you all can see my
Yes.
I have 4 applications here. Okay. The first application is AEZ screen recorder. I'm going to explain about AEZ screen recorder. I'm clicking on that. You can download this from Play Store. It is available in Android phones. AEZ screen recorder. Once I click that, you can see the shortcut. You can see this shortcut. With this one application, you can create the entire video. I'll show you how. We click on this. There are four options you can see. The first one is video. From the symbol, you can understand it is video. And the second one is gallery. So whatever you're creating with this application, it will be available in the gallery. Next is settings. Next is live. So I'll explain you one by one. First, let me go to the settings. So in the settings, it has three options. One is screenshot. If you enable screenshot, you will get another shortcut for screenshot. If you click on that, it is asking AZ screen recorder will start capturing everything that displays on your screen. So it is capturing. See, immediately after it captured the picture, it's showing. If I want to share, I can share. If I want to crop or if I want to edit something, so if I want to edit something, I can edit, crop the picture. This cropping option is available here, crop. And this one is delete. If you're not satisfied with your picture, you can delete this. And the next one is share. You can directly share this picture. Okay, this is about this application. That is one of the application in AZ screen recorder, that is screenshot. The second is, again, I'm going to setting. I can enable camera. See, you can see me in the camera. I can enable camera. I'm closing this now. You can also change the camera, like front view. This is front view. And this is, that is back view and this is front view. And you can delete or you can make it bigger as you like. Yeah. Then again, I'm going to setting. There is another option called brush. If I click on brush, can you see the shortcut here? Here, there is the shortcut. Where you can open the camera. The first one is camera. Another one is you can select the color you want for this writing, for brushing. Another one is undo. If you click undo, whatever I have done will be deleted automatically. And if you want to delete the entire thing, you can delete. So this is another option. Now I'm going to record a video. So only three options are available in this recording toolbox: screenshot, camera, and brush. Now, I have a PPT in my phone. So I have already having one PPT in my phone. Now I'm going to play that particular PPT. And now I'm going to take the brush. See, I kept everything ready. The PPT I kept ready and my camera is on. Now I'm going to record. Let's keep rotating. So recording has started. Now I can teach. So today in this session, I'm going to talk about internet-based brush I'm taking. Internet-based. I don't know why it's keep. So it's actually recording. It has already recorded 26 seconds. It's keep recording the video. Whatever displayed on my screen, it will record. Whenever you want brush, you can use the brush. Or else you can just close it. This is one application. If you have given a lot of animations in the PPT itself, here itself you can play all the animations. You no need to go and search for some other source to explain the things. So if you keep everything ready with the PPT, with your face, you can teach. And after I stop the recording, it will automatically saved in my gallery that you can share with your students. I'm just stopping the recording. So it is showing that whether I want to share or delete or whatever I want to do, I can do. It is already saved in my gallery. Then another option is there, live. If you click on live, it shows your Facebook Live and YouTube Live. From this application itself, you can directly take a live class in YouTube or Facebook. So it is very easy. You can also use this live option with this application. These are the options available. One is live. With the live, you can take classes live in Facebook and YouTube. With the settings, you have only three options: screenshot, camera, and brush. And you have to keep everything ready before starting the session. Then you have to press the video. Then you can start taking the class. And after completing the video, if you press the stop button, it will automatically save to your gallery. That's it about this video. Is it clear? Or you want me to repeat?
Yeah, fine. I think we can get an opinion from the audience also.
Yes, sir.
Participant, you can unmute yourself and then you can share your experience. Then we give them a time for them to download and then check the instruction given to them. Dear participant, unmute yourself. And some of them, they commented that they are not able to know where to use the recorder. They can't find it.
Pardon, sir?
Some of them in said, informed in the chat box that they are not able to find out A to Z recorder. Screen recorder is not available in the app store. So they are using iPhone, they are not able to download, I think.
Yeah, it is. In the beginning itself, I told it is available with Android.
Okay. Dear partner, yes, I think there is a person, those are using iPhone, they informed that they are not available with screen recorder.
See, I have two phones. I know this problem. We cannot download and use everything in iPhone. That's why it is one. Whoever is having iPhone, they must have this Android phone also.
And there is a definitely alternative will be there, no, ma'am.
Yeah, sir.
See, those are using iPhone. You can find out the screen recording applications. You can check it and then you can find out screen recording application.
A is a screen recorder.
Yes.
There are many recording applications are there. A is a screen, V recorder is there. But the icon for this application is unique.
4.6. Yeah. Point is.
Is that clear, sir?
Yes, clear. I think many of them are not coming forward to share their experience. I'll do one thing. Voluntarily, I'll ask one of the participants. I'll do one thing. Prabhavati? Hello? Prabhavati, are you there? I think many of the participants were attending, putting their mobile phone, and I think they are not listening. That's why I said without getting videos from them, you should not use the video. Yeah, it is a one check. I think we are randomly Hello. Selected the participant. I will ask one more random.
Hello.
Yeah, yes. Dr. Munis,
Hello.
Please go ahead.
Sir, it is a wonderful session is going on. Definitely, we will use and I will find this application on my Android phone. And definitely, Dr. John CPA is elaborating the contents very well, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay. So, can you able to get all the points from the resource person?
Yes, sir. Yeah. And I am noting down right now, sir. I show my video, sir.
Okay.
I am writing down all the points.
Okay, sir. Fine, sir. Ma'am, we can proceed. Dr. Jain, say you can. Next topic.
Long press. You can delete it. Okay, next application is animated text.
Yes.
Okay, with this application, we can make two things. One is GIF. GIF is animated image, and a short video we can make. So I'm going to start this. For that, you have to press the start button. Yeah. Whenever you start this, you can see a sentence. It is automatic. Randomly, you will get some sentences whenever you open this application. So there is a tick mark you can see on the top. If you press on the tick mark, it opens four other options. One is camera. With this, you can make video with the pictures. You cannot upload any video with this. You can upload images, and you can add text, and you can give some animation to the text alone. You cannot give animation to the images that you are including in this. So if you want to take a picture with the camera, first you can take a picture. You can open up this and take the picture. Or if you have any images inside your gallery, you can tap on this. This one is for images. You can tap on this and you can upload the image here. Then this one is playing option. Another one is delete. Now I'm not going to use this camera because I'm not going to take any picture. I don't have any material like that to capture now. So I'm directly going to gallery. Or else I can instantly go to Google. Then I'm typing some, I'm just downloading some image from Google. I'm going to make animated text for the concept perception. The perception, I'm clicking on images. You can select, I'm selecting this. Download image, downloading. Okay, I've downloaded the image from Google Chrome. Now, I'm opening this animated text. See, it has come to my gallery. Now, I'm selecting this image. You can, there is a fixed screen position. So, whatever position you want, you can select and you can get. Click OK. Now, here they have already given a sentence. We are not going to do anything with this. So I'm deleting this just by pressing the back key. I'm pressing the back key. Okay. Now you can see the pointer. Now I'm going to type the content. The process of interpreting okay. After typing the text, I'm giving the tick mark. Okay. Now I'm playing this. See, you can see the animated text now. So there are some options at the bottom. So with these options, you can change. See, suppose if I look at this, it is purple in color, and the text is yellow. So it won't change the entire background into purple, but it gives some effect to the background image. So the text is in yellow. If I click on this, you can see the slight difference in the background image, but the text has become black. This one, the background little bit bluish and the text is in white color. It's black. Okay, now I wanted to do some animation for this sentence. For that you have to use these options. Mask. See, perception, everything is rolling, just the text is rolling on the image. Mean. So perception is a process of interpretation. Down you have seen the remaining sentence. Then focus. You can use trailer. See, you can make now it is over. I think it, you can understand. Follow me.
Yes.
Now there are four options on the top. So there are only two options with this particular application. One is you can change the background, as well as that is you can give filter to the background, and you can add the text. And another option is you can make whatever style you want using this. If you want blink, you can use blink. If you want trailer, you can use that. Anything you want, you can use. So on the top, you can see four options. One is WhatsApp symbol, another one is Instagram, another one is share, another one is download. Four options. If you want to send this directly from this application to the WhatsApp, you have to click on WhatsApp. Or if you want to send this video to the Instagram, you can click on this and directly send. Or if you want to send to some other application, or you may want to send to Gmail, email, then share. If you click on share also, you'll get all the applications that you have in your phone. And this is download. Now I'm going to download this. See, when I click on download, whatever you click, if you click on WhatsApp also, you'll get two options, share as GIF or share as video. If you click on Instagram, there also you'll get two options, share as GIF or share as video. I'm downloading this. If you want to make this text as GIF, you can click on GIF, but I'm going to make this as video. So I'm clicking on save as video. So the process is going on. Please wait. Building your story project as MP4. So this one you can use when you are editing your main video. This text you can use. There in editing software, you can just display the text with different colors, but you cannot add some animation like this to the text in the editing app. So you can do this with the help of this small apps you can use, and then you can put it in the final editing.
Amazing.
So when you use Android phone, you'll get all these disturbances of advertisements. Please ignore. For that, you have to use iPhone. I have downloaded this. I'm going to check that in my gallery. It's not here. See, this is the final result. This you can share with. You can share with any application you want. Is it clear, sir? Only two options. One is background and text color. Another one is giving some style or animation to the text. Is it clear?
Yes, yes.
Shall I move to the next?
Yes.
Sir.
Sir, Naga Subramani, sir, clear?
Clear, ma'am, clear.
Okay. Okay. Now this is a Viva video that I will explain later. Now we are going to move on to the application that is available with your laptop. You can make a video with that also. This is the photo. Can you see my screen? Laptop screen, sir?
No, we can able to see only your mobile screen. Can you stop this screen sharing and then again you can do that.
Sir, I struggled a lot to connect this. I want to come back to this later.
Yes, like... we can complete with the mobile application and then you can...
No, sir, that one editing, if you finish this and do only, it will be nice.
Okay.
You're not able to see my...
No, we can able to see on your mobile screen.
Okay, I'm disconnecting this now.
You have to stop it. Stop the screen sharing. Yes.
Okay, sir. Okay. Now we are going to make completely animated video. Completely. 100% animated video. You may think whether you are going to do animation. No. There are some animated clips are there. You are going to add only text in that. So I'm directly going to Google. There you can type render forest. So render forest. Okay. You can see the first link, render forest, online video, logo, and website maker. Click on this.
Yes.
And get started. See, in this this website, you have to log in. Why? Because if you log in only, you can download the video. Otherwise, you can just make the animation. You can view online, but you cannot download. So if you want to download, you have to log in. Sometimes this video, when you are creating the final step, it won't create immediately. Because of some network problem or whatever it may be, it won't create. It will take long time. That time they'll send you a notification that once the video is created, it will be mailed to you later. So we can download the video, the final result from your mail ID. So now you have to sign in. For that, you no need to create any separate account. You can sign in from your Facebook account or from Google. I'm going to sign in with my Google account. Okay. See, now I got signed in. You can see my name. These are some animations that are available in this website. You're just going to click and do the text. Just going to add the text. If you see this whiteboard animation, it has 1,000 scenes. Can you see? The whiteboard animation toolkit includes 1,000 screens, scenes. So here you have to your idea, which screen you want, which animation picture you want for your text, you have to think and select. That is more important. So the text and the animation should give a message. You cannot give the animation for the decoration purpose. It should have some meaning. I'm selecting whiteboard animation. So create now. Click on create now.
Yes.
Okay. It is asking add scene. choose from ready-made stories. If you want to use anything already created from this website, you can click on this and you can use the ready-made stories. Type your script for that, you can see. Now I'm going to add scene. See, there are a lot of options like casual male character animation. This is, and that too, happy man, waving man. You would have seen this animation in YouTube.
Yes.
You may be surprising how they are making this. You may be thinking that we need special skill to do all this. It's nothing. They are just downloading from this and adding text. Okay. So wave man, waving man, and then sad man, man with icon. Corporate male character. That was casual. This is corporate, so he's wearing suit and all. Next is casual female character. This is casual female character, corporate female character, casual characters group. Okay. Background animation. Okay. Now I'm just selecting some casual female character. I'm adding scene. So first, I'm taking happy women. When I click, you can see this enable and enable deselect scenes and interest. Sorry, insert the application. These buttons are enabled. So I'm clicking on this. So here you have to add the text. I'm just typing hi everyone. Hi everyone. Save and close. Now I'm going to add another scene. I'm selecting this woman riding a bicycle. I'm inserting the scene. I'm just clicking on type your text. So I'm just typing. I went for cycling yesterday. Save and close. Again, it is getting processed. Then I'm clicking on another option here, plus. I'm going to add another scene. I'm selecting this. Here I am adding text like I met with an accident.
Genius.
Save and close. It is ready now. If you want to duplicate, you can duplicate, or if you don't like any of the scene, you can replace it, or if you want to remove, you can remove. See, once if you have done this, there'll be preview option. I'm just checking for again. Setting another screen. The end. Save. Here you can see preview. Can you see preview here? So I'm going to click this preview. Pre-preview. It is processing. So it will take some time. So by the time I'll just go to my video. See, you have plenty of options. I cannot explain everything in this class itself because it will take a lot of time. I've told you the website address. Now it is your job. Ball is on your court. You have to explore all these options. So I'm just clicking on my video. That I'm
and the opening show.
Dear participant, please mute your audio. Yes.
So my video is successfully exported. Okay, now I'm going to play, or if you want you can download. If you want this to be in HD high definition, you have to purchase. It's in every application. There may be a lot of features, but only few you can use as free, and remaining thing if you want to use, then you have to pay and buy. So if you want, you can download or you can just play. Okay, sir, or you want me to repeat again?
Wonderful.
That is good, fine.
Okay, anyway, I'll tell you once again.
Yes.
Go to Google, Render Forest, open this, get started. What do you want to create? Video? Create video? There are a lot of options. You can click on anyone. Now I've created, I'm going to create multicolor blast logo. Create now. It is processing. And if you want to add text or images in this, you can add. Here, this particular edit image. If you want to add image, you can add for this, or if you want to edit only the text, you can do. Then if you want this to download, you have to click on preview. That is more important. If you click on preview only, you can that will get processed. There is no save option. Only preview is the only option. When you preview, it will get processed and you can download, or you can delete, or you can share it with someone. Anything it is possible only with this preview option. So that's it. I'm moving on to the next application. Sir, be able to see my screen?
No, ma'am. No. No.
My laptop screen?
No, it is not visible. Yes. Mirror go.
Now?
Now we can see your mobile screen. 11:22 a.m. Thursday, May 28, 2020 is visible for me.
Okay. I'm not getting the option of sharing my desktop, sir.
No, you can do one thing. Stop screen first. Already you are sharing your screen. Stop.
I stopped it.
Then you can open that window which you want to share. Then come to the share screen. Then that will be there in that preview. Now it is.
You can see yes.
Yes. Yes.
See here, what I'm saying is, I can see my Google. If I open this, I can see this.
Okay.
But I'm not getting the option of displaying my desktop screen. No. Share option.
Yahoo is there visible. Hot potatoes. Now I can see that Yahoo screen. In your desktop, I can able to see now.
Can you see the desktop?
Yes, it's visible now. Yes.
Desktop is visible.
Yes.
Okay.
Yahoo. In that window.
No, that is application that I have opened.
Okay, you have to close that, then you have to come back again. In the share screen, again you have to click and then you can find out your desktop will be there. Just check it.
That is what, sir, I'm saying. Desktop option is not visible here.
Okay.
Showing only the mobile. Maybe I have to disconnect my phone.
No, you can full screen. You can share now. Whatever the things are there in your laptop, desktop, you can share it. An option is there. I will do one thing. I'm starting my screen sharing. It is saying that you are using it.
Sir, I cannot open my desktop. That option is not showing.
Okay. And
only whiteboard, my mobile application, and Google Chrome. Only three options I can see on share screen.
I will do only, I will try from here. No, mine is everything is visible. For me, desktop and everything is visible. There are basic, advanced and files are there. Can you check from that? Share computer.
Yeah, there also I checked. Music, computer, sound only, second camera. Two options.
Mm-hmm.
Files also, we cannot use that.
I can able to see in my screen, there are 8 windows I can able to share from here. Whiteboard, that my browser, WhatsApp. Now we can able to see that your browser window only.
Browser window, that option is there. The desktop option is not there.
I will do one thing. I will check it from here.
Sir, I'm going to editing option. Better.
Okay, madam. You can proceed.
Now, can you see my mobile phone?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, I'm going to explain about this editing application, Viva Video. There are many applications available in Play Store. If you learn from one, you can download other application and you can start using it because the options will be same in everything. So I'm just clicking on Vivo Video. So it has some options like shoot, convert, video saver, edit, my draft, slideshow, everything. I'm going to edit my video. So I'm going to click on edit. Okay. Once I click on edit, I think you may be remembering this one I created with AZ, this particular application I created with AZ screen recorder. Now I don't want that. I'm selecting some videos from here. So here you can have your videos created by animated text or videos created by A to Z that you can include in the editing option, and you can edit that. So I selected the video and you can see all the videos have come. I've selected some 6-7 videos. All have come. Now, so it is, see, you can see you are using VIP functions or materials. Click to view. I don't want this. If you get VIP, then you can use all the options available with this. Next. Okay. Now the videos are not in order, so this must be the first one. So I'm just clicking on this and I'm moving. So when you long press on any video clip, it'll get selected and you can move, you can position it wherever you want. Now, there are 5 options here. In the bottom most, you can see there are 5 options. One is theme, another one is music, next is clip edit, then text fix and filter. So first I'm going to demonstrate about clip edit. So clip edit, the first option is canvas. In canvas, you can see lot of size and position of the screen. See here given, you can adjust the size and position of the clips on the canvas. If I click on this option, you can see the video display is changing. But I feel that this particular display will be correct for my video, so I'm selecting on that and pressing on OK. Then next option is trim. If you click on trim, it is opening your videos. And for example, I want only this portion. I don't want the remaining portion. So what I can do is I can just select the trim option. If I click OK, then remaining thing will be deleted. So only the clip that I have selected, you can see. So if you have done wrongly, no need to worry. There is undo option on the top. You can see on the top, there is undo option. If you undo, you can see the entire video. Then in trim, if I go, there is another option called cutout. Cutout, see, I don't want some scenes in the middle of the video. If I don't want some scenes on the middle of the video, I can select, I can play that, and I can see. See, I don't want this particular clip. So I've selected. Then if I click on the stick button, it will be deleted. And the first portion and the second portion will get merged automatically. So back button. So I'm not going to cut out anything from this picture. It asked me to discard the changes, so I discarded that. Then next option is split. See? This is one complete clip. I just want to split this clip. So I'll be selecting on split. It gets splitted automatically. You can see the difference. I'm giving undo. Now it merged. Now it is one video now. I'm clicking on split. It has become two different videos. You can trim your video by using the trim option, or you can edit here itself just by clicking on split. And if you select this, you can give delete. So split and delete also you can use to trim your video, or else you can go directly to the trim and you can trim the video. There are two options. And if I see this particular clip, if I play this particular clip, you can see it is going very slow. Slowly she's making some picture. So I don't want this to be very slow. I want to speed up this process. So I'm just clicking on speed. Or if you want to slow down, you can slow down. When I slow down, you can see that the video is getting enlarged. When I speed up, you can see the size of the video is getting decreased. So I'm just giving 3x. If I play this, you can see that it is going a little bit faster. Now if I give the full, if you give slow, it will go very slow. Okay, this is the, I'm discarding the change, the speed option. Next, volume. There is no volume in this video. Actually, I'm going to add volume to this, audio to this. If you want to increase the audio, you can use this volume button. Next, mute. Actually, if you see in this video, if I play, you can see the background noise, like a fan is, the rotation of the fan sound, and some people are moving around. So that noise and all you can hear from this video. I don't want all that noise. I'm going to include a new audio for this video. So I'm going to mute this. If I mute, this particular clip audio is muted. Here you can see the voice. So for every clip, you have to mute the audio. See? Can you hear what she's saying? Okay, now I'm going to mute this clip audio. If I play now, you cannot hear any voice. When I mute this, automatically you can see the volume is getting zero. Okay. Then the next option is voice changer. The voice changer we cannot use because this is VIP option. Once if you purchase this particular application, you can just use this voice changer. The voice changer you can give like, you know, robotic voice or mild voice, like child talking, like Tom and Jerry talking, anything like that. You can, there are plenty of options. We cannot open this. You cannot open this because it is VIP option. Next is transition. So transition is nothing but, see, you can see the symbol here, transition symbol. The same symbol you can see between the two clips. Transition symbol that you are seeing here, you can see the same symbol between the clips. So I'm clicking on transition. There will be plenty of transition option you have to select. See, upright, downright, dark, fade, or erase. So I'm going to give erase. I've selected this under erase. I selected this fiber. This fiber I've selected. I'm clicking OK. Now the transition is added. See here the transition, you can see the symbol. It is just, no, the triangles are dim, very dim. It means that here no transition are added. Here you can see that the transition triangles are bold, dark. So it means that you have already added the transition to the video. Now I'm playing this. See the effect you have seen? Transition. So like that you can give transition to every video clip. The next is adjust. In adjustment, you have two options, filter and effect. This adjustment option is available only for VIP. Those who have bought this application can use this option, others can't use. So I'm going to use filter and effect. These are filter option are available in normal mobile phone also. Whenever we take video, we use some filter to take snaps. The same thing are here. But we have plenty of options like leak, dynamic, VHS, cinema. I'm giving cinema. It will be very nice to see. It will be like real cinema. So whatever you add, you have to add it for every clip. That is more important. If you want one clip to be in some filter, some effect, or you want another clip to be in another effect, you can give according to your choice. Okay. Filter is just giving some effect to the picture. And effect is, you get some effect to the picture. See the effect. I've given two options. One is filter, so it is little bit no, you can see the lights, pink lights coming around. And I also given the effect, so it is coming, zooming in, zooming out. Okay. Then I'm giving save. I need to save this. Let me come. Okay. Now adding text. Transition you have seen. In the adjustment, you can filter and do effect, give effect to the video. The same thing is here also, filter. Either you can do your filter and effect with this adjustment, clicking on this, or you can do from here. Both are same, no difference. Next, watermark. If you want to include any watermark, like, you know, after creating the video, you can see this view of video. This thing will be seen from the beginning till the end of the video. So if you want to give some watermark like this for the entire video, for example, if you want to add the name, see, but this option is only for VIP, those who have bought this application, not for everyone. And reverse. See, when I click on reverse, the front will play at the back. It will get reversed. See, whatever effect you are giving, that is only for that particular clip that we have selected and giving. It is not applicable for the entire clip. So now it plays backward. You cannot see much difference in this video. Could have seen in some famous songs and all, they'll play backward. Lip syncing with lip syncing, they play one of the famous song by Kamal Haasan also there. If you remember. Then rotate. If you want to rotate this particular clip, I'm giving application, all the applications to only this clip. Rotate. You can rotate. Or you want the same clip again. One more clip you want, the same thing. For example, you have given all the animations for this particular clip and you want the same thing again, you can just click on duplicate so that you'll get another clip of same type. Now, editing is over. Editing, canvas tells about the screen size you want to display. Trim, you can trim the video. Split and delete if you use, you can also do the same thing that you can do with trim. Then speed up, mute, transition, adjustment, reverse and everything. Sort, it's nothing but you can sort which one you want first, second. You can select and sort this, which one you want first, which clip you want second, that is sort. Next, theme. Usually for educational video we won't use any theme. And if you use also, if you want, you can use that also. I'm clicking on one theme. It's getting downloaded and it is getting processed. See. See. Like that. There are plenty of themes. Under love, under birthday, there are plenty. Festivals, there are plenty. So when you apply theme to the video, it will be applied for the entire video, not for particular clip. It is applied for entire video. Next is music. Here, see, there are three options in music. One is add music. Another one is add voice over. Another one is add sound effects. So basically, this video is not having any music. I'm going to add music. If I click on add music, you can see lot of music clips that are already available, audio clips that are already available with the application. You can select anyone. You can just play Bollywood. Okay. If you click on this side, you can hear the audio. And if you click on this side, it will get downloaded to your video. I'm going to click here. I'm not okay with the sound because it will not be suitable for the video that I've taken. Select something from class. Okay, I'm going to select this. I'm going to give this download. Getting downloaded. Now it is showing use. I'm click on use. Now for the entire video, I have added this audio clip. You can see the blue thing, and you can see the name of the audio I've included. Now if I play, okay, this is one option. Second option is add over voice. If I click on this add over voice, it shows a button called start. You click on the start and you can talk. Here you are doing dubbing. Here you are doing dubbing. If I start, click on start, whatever I am saying, it is getting recorded with the video. Okay, so I'm stopping this. I'm just pressing the OK button. Now I want the, I don't want this background sound, so I'm just muting that, or I'm just giving zero to that particular audio clip. This one I want the dubbing. So now I'm playing this.
Click on start. Whatever I'm saying, it is getting recorded with the video. Okay, so I'm stopping.
Okay, so add sound effects. If you want to add any sound effects, you can add according to your need. There are plenty. You need around 1 month to explore all the options in the video clip. Okay, I think I've said everything. I said about themes, I said about music. Music, three options. You can add music. You can, or you can start talking on your own and record it. Or you can also add sound effects. And here also there are plenty of options. Canvas, trim, split, everything I told. Then text. Here I'm going to add text. Adding text. Hi everyone. I'm clicking OK. So if I click on this, if you don't want, you can delete this. If you just put your finger on that, you can move wherever you want. I wanted to have this clip, this particular text here. I want this to be a little bit bigger. So in the corner, you can see some adjustment. With that, you can make it bigger. Then in edit, first one is keyboard. Next, you can add style to the text you have included. You can also see the font style. I'm clicking on style. This is just the color. There are plenty you can give. Bubble kind of thing also you can give. Hi everyone. Hi everyone. See the bubble. Be animated
with the video. Okay.
Then font. If you click on font, you have some options like font size, increase or decrease. And you can change the style of the font. Here you can give border. I'll select some good. Giving border to the text. You can see the difference. And shadow. Now this is without shadow. If I click it on, you can see the shadow. Next, animation is already on. Alignment. If you want this one, no, if you add big sentences in the text box, then you can use this for this alignment. Because we have added only two words, so you cannot see any alignment here. you want duplicate the text, you can duplicate. If you don't want, you can delete. You can click here and delete, or you can delete directly from this. It will go. Then sticker. If you want to add any sticker to the video, you can add.
So I'm stopping.
If you want this to be bigger, you can enlarge.
So I'm stopping.
Yeah, that's all. These things are for VIP effect. This is all just effect. You can see the effect on the video. Hello, sir?
Yes, yes,
sir.
Sir, it's clear, sir?
Yes, clear.
Very clear, sir. I think
now we can
see. Having one more application in my laptop.
Okay.
That I was not able to do because I couldn't share my desktop.
Can you open that application? Then you can try to share your screen.
Yeah, I'll try.
You can open that application, then try to share your screen. Then there may be a chances. I think that participants are.
Content. Yeah, sir, it is coming. Yeah, correct.
Yeah. Right. Yes. I think we need 5 more days to learn from you.
Sir, you can explore. It's very easy.
Yes.
Okay.
Not from me. The comments from the participants only.
Oh, really? Thank you, sir. Anyway, thank you. Then tell Nagasubramaniam, sir, to have such a workshop for 1 week.
Definitely. Each application, you have to spend at least 1 day. Then only they can able to come out with that potential skill on that application.
Yes, yeah, sir. Yes. Okay, sir. Next is, I'm going to share next application. Can you see the application, sir?
Yes, yes. Welcome to Photo Story 3 for Windows.
Yeah. Yeah, welcome to Photo Story 3 for Windows.
Instead of next, I think you have cancelled.
I wanted to show it from my... Okay. Now?
No. I have to again open. I think instead of...
Open.
No, I have to again share it.
Okay, I'll share it.
Now it is visible, yes.
So because of this Zoom, plenty of things are getting opened in my screen, getting distraction. Okay. Now, there are 3 options in Photo Story. Actually, you can download this application from Google. I'll first share my Google page. Typing Google. If I type Photo Story, so you can see download Photo Story 3 for Windows XP. You have to click on this. So it is asking to select language. You can select English. It is already default. And if you click on download, it will get downloaded to your desktop. So it is a simple process. You can download. For this, you can work offline. No need to go online, or you no need of any internet connectivity for this particular application to be used. Whereas for Render Forest, you can do everything online only. Now I'm closing this application. Now I'm sharing my Photo Story application. Okay. Now begin a new story. this is this particular application we can use only the pictures, images. You cannot include any video clip or GIF file to this. With the picture, with your own voice, you can create a story or you can create an educational content. Okay. Already I have selected some pictures from the Google and I have kept it in separate folder. I kept everything ready. Now I'm going to begin a new story. If you have done already, you can give edit a project or play a story. Now I'm going to click on begin a new story. So I'm giving next. Okay. So the first window is import and arrange your pictures. Import and arrange your pictures. I'm just clicking on import pictures. Okay, I have these pictures in my desktop in a separate folder. This is about Maslow's theory of hierarchy of needs. So I'm selecting all the pictures by pressing Control key and with the mouse. All the pictures. So whatever image you want, you can put it in separate folder so that it will be easy for you to import. I'm clicking OK. All the pictures got imported in this particular application. Now, here two options are given, import and arrange your pictures. So now I have done one job. Next, I have to arrange the pictures. I want this picture of Maslow to be on the first, and I want the pyramid in the second, and this one is level 4. I want it in level 4. And this one, self-actualization is lost. This is level 3 I'm arranging. Just long press on the particular image, it will get selected and you can move anywhere you want. So level 1, it's level 2, level 3, level 4 and level 5. Okay, so now this is in order. Or you can select the picture and you can use this button also to move. The two options, one, you can hold on the picture and you can move. Other options, you can just click on this arrow button to move front and back. Okay. Here, you can see some edit options. This is color editing. It won't give you much color difference. A little bit of difference you can see in the image. It's just limited options only available with this particular application. If you want to rotate the image, you can rotate. Okay. If you go to edit, there are some options like crop the picture, rotate. Crop. See, already my picture is good. I don't want to crop this. So I'm unselecting this. Autofix. In autofix, you can give correct contrast correction. You can give color levels. But this is just limited option. You can just off and on. You cannot make any moves to make it a little more brighter or a little more lighter. That option is not possible with this application. The next is add effect. Yeah, add effect also, there are plenty of options like black and white. If you want chalk and charcoal, kind like some kind of drawing, if you want negative kind of thing, watercolor. So these things are not suitable for this particular picture. So I'm clicking on none. For some picture, you may use these options. For this particular picture, it is already clear. I don't want to use any effect. I'm closing this. Do you want to save the changes? No. Okay. So this is the first window of this particular application. I'm clicking on next. It is saying that your pictures are having black borders. See, it's talking about this border. Here black, you can see here black. It is talking about these black borders. It is telling me to remove. I don't want to remove this because in animation portion, I'll do some animations to this. So I don't want to remove this. I wanted to continue with the same picture. So do you want to continue without removing black border? I'm just clicking on no. Next. Okay. This is next window. Add a title to your picture. See, if you see the pictures, other pictures are having its title. See, this picture is having self-actualization. This picture is level for esteem, everything. Come here. It has the title there itself. But I wanted to add title for the psychologist. So that I can type here. Type text to add a title on the selected picture. So here I'm going to add the text. Maslow's theory of needs, hierarchy of needs. Okay, now I've typed. Now the text is appearing on the face of the psychologist. I want it on the bottom, so I'm selecting here bottom, and this is black in color. I cannot see the entire thing, so I wanted to add some color to this. I'm clicking on this A, select font. I'm clicking on this select font. Okay. Here you can give font type you want. You can give font style you want. You can increase the size or decrease the size of the font. And if you want to strike out the font, you can click on this. I don't want this underline. Even I don't want this to use for this particular image. So I'm unclicking on this. Then the color is black. So I'm going to use some bright color like yellow. The script, Western. Only one option is available. So Western, that's what we are using, the script. So that is enough, yellow. So all font related changes you can make with this window. Click OK. So in this add title, you have two options. One is font style selection and modification. Another thing is alignment of the font. Now it is clear. I wanted to make this little more darker. Edit, add effect, black and white. Okay. Okay, you can select the color according to your need. You can select the font style, font size according to your need. Now this portion is, the second part is, add title to your picture is over. For every picture, you can see this window. For every picture, you click on this, you can see the options for changing the font style, aligning the font. If you want to add text to each and every picture, you can add, but the pictures that I have taken is already having the title of that particular picture, so I'm not adding this. So the second window is over. I am moving on to the third window. Yeah, the third window, you can give some motions and you can give audio. So once if you click on this record narration button, this audio will get started and whatever you speak will be recorded along with that picture. If you want to add a, see, type notes here to aid your memory as you narrate your this picture. So when you talk, you may think that you may forget some of the lines, or in that case, you can just type everything here for your memory. I would say that no need to type here. You can just write everything on a paper and you can read from that. Or else if you feel that this will be convenient, typing everything on that particular page and reading out from that will be convenient, then you can use that also. Now, I'm just clicking on record narration. So now the recording has started. Whatever I talk will be get recorded along with that picture. So for this particular picture, if I want to talk for 1 minute, I can talk and then stop. So that 1 minute you can see this picture displayed on the screen. And this one is okay. I'm going to stop this recording. And I want to do some recording for the second picture. Then I can start recording. So whatever I say is getting recorded along with this picture. So I wanted to record. See, you no need to stop every time. You can just click on another slide. You can keep talking. It will get recorded. See, I'm clicking on this image. You can see it's starting from one. So you can also see this image below every picture. It shows that you have some audio to this, and it's showing the first picture is having 23 seconds audio, the second picture is having 6 seconds audio, the fourth picture is having 10 seconds audio, the third one. Okay, now the recording is over. I'm going to stop this. Now customize motion. Here again, transition. This transition we have already done in our viewer video also. I told you the same transition option is available with this particular application also. Here, motion and duration. See, specify start and end position of motion. For this particular picture, I don't want to have any start and end position. I want this picture to be displayed in the same way from the end of from the starting till the end of the video. So I'm not going to apply anything for this. I'm closing this. But I want to do some motion to this particular picture. So customize motion. See? Specify start and end position of motion. This is the start position. So when you click on playing video, you can see this particular position first, and then slowly it will move and end up with this position. There you can see some movement in the picture. So we are giving some movement to the picture. Okay, there are some more options here. Start, select position to be same as end position of the previous picture. It means that the start position and end position will be same for this picture, so that you won't see this particular portion of the picture. You cannot see this. You can see only this from the start and end of the picture. Or the second option is select end position to be same as the start position. Here, end position and the start position, you can see only this image. See, start and end will be same. Set duration automatically. Set duration automatically, it will play for 10 seconds. I want it for some 20 seconds. Then I can increase the number of seconds to display. So I've kept 20 seconds. If I preview this, see? Okay, I'll show you the preview after completing all the animations. Now, transition. Here, this one is previous picture, this one is current picture. They have given lot of transition options here. According to your taste and need of the video, you can select from this. See, you can see the output here. The middle picture, this is previous, this is current, and middle you can see the effect of the transition. Okay, done. So like that you can give transition and motion duration to each and every picture you have. Now close. Yes. Okay. Then next. So we have so far seen three options of this particular application. I'm clicking on next. See here, add background music. Already I have given voice. If you don't want to use any voice, just you want a music, you can select music from your laptop. If you click on select, so it is showing some musics that I have already having in my laptop. I can select any one music from this. I'm just clicking on this, putting open. Okay. Now I have added the background music also. You can see this here. Made with the Rexon hair. Now you can adjust the volume. If you want this music to play in a very low sound, you can keep it low, or if you want it to be high, you can make it high. So create music. If you want to create your own music, or you want to record from your some other application, like or from your other devices like mobile phone, you can record here and you can use it. I'm not going to create any music here, so I'm canceling this. And if you don't want, you can delete this also, music. So now I'm clicking on next. I think after this we don't have any other option to do, so I'm just going to preview this entire video. Can you hear, sir? Subramanian, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, yes.
Can you hear the voice of this particular...
Yes, ma'am. Yes, yes.
Okay. See, the music is a little bit low, high, so I'm going to... You can hear the music I have selected is playing with a very low volume at the background, like a background sound. Now that's all. You can preview. See, this is the motion. How it is moving. The picture is moving. I've given motion to this particular picture, so it is moving. I didn't give any motion to this picture, so it is just showing, just displaying on the screen. So this picture has also got some motion. Okay. Posting this. Next. So it is asking, save your story for playback on your computer. I'm selecting on this because I'm going to save it in my computer. Next. It is just processing and downloading in my computer. Okay. It is downloaded. I can see the complete video in my desktop. I can click on that. I'm just going to click on that. Can you see that, sir?
I'm only completing photo story windows.
Okay, sir, wait.
Your story.
Can you see now, sir?
Yeah, now it is visible.
It's playing as a video.
Yeah, yeah.
This is the output. Simply, you can do it with the pictures available, and you can give the narration to the story. You can create your own educational video. It will take just 10 minutes to produce this video. It won't confuse you also with a lot of options. It has few options, giving motion, adding animation, like adding music. Only few options are available in this, so it is easy for us to make complete video. That's all, sir.
Okay. I think, can you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes, I think Dr. Jans, it is an amazing presentation. You can see that the comment box is running with positive feedback regarding your presentation. I think I would like to give one recommendation to the coordinator. Please have a few more workshop on with Jansi ma'am for each application one day. Then only that all the teachers will be master in that applications. And I would like to say that even I too thought of giving some instruction regarding that DO recorder. The DO recorder information is already discussed with in other name, in the other application name by Dr. Jansi. I think she made my presentation very easy in the evening time. So thank you so much, Dr. Jansi, for amazing presentation. Yes, dear participant, would you like to say something to the resource person? You can unmute yourself and then you can share the knowledge to the resource person. Dear participant, you can unmute yourself. You can share your experience and today's learning to the resource person. Yes. I think I can see the smile in everyone's face. It shows that you I think you enjoyed the learning today. I think you will. Yeah.
Hi, sir.
Yes, sir, you can say, sir.
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir, you can say.
Sir, actually, I am very much pleased with the madam's presentation.
Yes.
It is just like what we can call moving a window in a smooth manner. Madam has understood the virtual learner's phase of the learning. This is most important for the virtual learner. Yeah. And this kind of these instruction over this video conferencing, these mode of platforms are very useful to us, sir. So therefore, I will seek your all cooperation in this regard to conduct for 1 week in relation to all these apps and the all the software related all the virtual tools. Nag Subramanian sir is laughing right now. Please, sir, I am very much grateful to the madam in this regard. And we are infants and in this fields, so that you better to select what exactly needed for us, for the teacher educator, to present these things in future virtual classroom activities, sir. Thank you for you all, entire crew, for hosting such a wonderful and amazing event, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir, for your amazing feedback. I think your feedback is clear on about what she has done today. And anybody else can come for? Yes, sir.
Please, one more resource person is waiting.
Okay.
Sir,
Yeah, okay. Now you want to continue, sir?
Pandita Dev, ma'am. Yes. Just off
now. 5 to 10 minutes break to the participant. Or shall we continue?
No, sir. Yeah, 5 minutes break is... I think it is okay.
I think we have to walk.
Lot of inputs, yeah. I think.
The information overloaded.
Overloaded. Yeah, overwhelmed with all that what we heard.
Yes.
Sir,
actually, we need ma'am's email ID and contact number.
Definitely, that ma'am is there in that WhatsApp group. Whatever the message you can send it, you can play back. Okay.
And sir, this type of workshop should be for 1 week in future also, sir. Yes, we want
yes, I understand.
You organize for 1 week, sir.
Yes, we will arrange it.
definitely sir, we'll have it only 1 week, especially for Nancy ma'ams. We need 1 week. For me it is 1 day is enough for me. Yes. Okay, sir, we will give up 5 minutes. You can just roam there and then come back. We will continue the session. Another resource person will be introduced by the.